And the reality is, my brothers and sisters, that we find shirk is widespread amongst the people who call themselves Muslims. Sometimes it is just out of ignorance. Sometimes people think it is Islam. But this is the reality. I remember going to Pakistan. On every street corner, practically in cities, I saw a sign with a hand, with lines painted on it. You know what that means? That is a sign for a palm reader. Someone is going to read your palm and tell your fortune and tell you what's going to happen in your life. Wallahi, that's worse than alcohol. Alcohol is a sin. That is shirk. Because that is ascribing to a human being one of the qualities that only belongs to Allah. What is that? Ilmul ghayb. Yet you will find today many people will go to a man, they call him a sheikh. And they believe he is a holy man, and he will tell them, your child will be a boy, your daughter is sick. And I have met people like that. And I say, brother, you know, this man is upon falsehood. He is calling you to shirk. He claims, and his followers claim, that he has the knowledge of the unseen. And they say, oh, but I went to him, and he didn't know anything about me, and I sat there, and he said, your daughter's waiting in the car, and she's sick, you should go to her. You see? He knows the unseen. It's karama, it's a miracle. And they made shirk with Allah. You know why? Because shaitan fooled them. Because they didn't have knowledge. Because these people, magicians, fortune tellers, palm readers, and some people who pretend to be pious, even they pray and they do many things of zuhud, but because of the shirk they make, shaitan cooperates with them. So the jinn is telling him, the shayateen is telling him about these things. So people will believe it and they will go astray. They believe someone had knowledge of the unseen. To believe someone can read from your palm your future is shirk. Because you believe they have the knowledge of the unseen. They look in the stars and I'm a Virgo, I'm a Leo, I'm a Pisces, I'm a this and that. And they're going to tell you what's going to happen tomorrow is shirk. You go to a soothsayer, he cuts open the animal and he looks at the heart and the testings and says, oh, this and that. And you believe he's going to cure you or help you, it's shirk. But you find these things widespread amongst the Muslims. Subhanallah.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the knower of the unseen. And that is an exclusive attribute. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He knows the unseen. And He does not let known, or He does not reveal that knowledge of the unseen to anyone except those chosen messengers. And He does that, why? As a type of proof that they are indeed the prophets of Allah. But even the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was only given a limited type of knowledge. He was not given absolute and unlimited knowledge of the unseen, because that is only an attribute that belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is so much better than believing in fortune tellers and astrologers and people like that and soothsayers who are only liars, who are pretending to know something they don't know, and also making shirk with Allah and forbidding yourself from paradise by believing in this superstitious nonsense. And you find even in the West that these things are very common, where you find in newspapers and magazines, horoscopes, where they claim to be able to tell you what is in your fate and what you should do and what you should look out for in the day to come, in the weeks to come, in the months to come, in the years to come. And all of these things, brothers and sisters, are lies. And if they happen to get something right, then it is simply because, as a lot of researchers found out, that they only write very general things that could apply to anybody. And the other thing that could happen, and this is for the people who really do magic, as we mentioned, they actually do have shayateen who listen to the angels discussing the matters that have been ordained by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they manage to get things right every now and then. But of course, this is also a lie and a deception. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who is the knower of the unseen. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the one who goes to a psychic or a fortune teller has disbelieved in what Allah revealed to Muhammad. And in another narration, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us that if you visit a fortune teller or a psychic, even out of curiosity, then your prayers will not be accepted for 40 days. Now that does not mean that you don't have to pray. No, you still have to pray because you have to fulfill the obligation of prayer, but you will not get the blessing and the reward of it. That's just from visiting a fortune teller out of curiosity. That includes, my brothers and sisters, picking up the newspaper and reading the star signs out of curiosity, or any other type of fortune telling thing out of curiosity. Tarot cards, where they put cards on the table and tell you what their fortune is. That is also fortune telling. It is shirk. If you believe in it, you have disbelieved in what Allah has revealed to Muhammad. And if you do it out of curiosity, your prayers will not be accepted. That includes palm reading, people who read the palms, or they look at the tea leaves. You know, after you've drinking your tea and they say, oh, this is what's going to happen to you. Or they look at the flights of birds and they predict what is going to happen by the flights of the birds, or by the insides and the entrails of animals. All of these things are omens. They are all fortune telling, and all of these things are shirk. They are all disbelief. None of those things have the ability to reveal the truth about the unseen. Only Allah knows the unseen, and He has given some of that knowledge to His chosen messengers, and there is no other way to know the unseen except that, my dear brothers and sisters. So Zayd bin Khalid Jahni related, radiallahu anhu related, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam led the dawn prayer at Hudaybiyah, and it rained during that night. So after finishing the prayer, he turned towards the people and he said, do you know what your Lord has said? They said, and they answered, Allah and His Messenger know best. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that Allah said, this morning some of my servants believed in me and they disbelieved in the stars. And some of my servants disbelieved in me and they believed in the stars. As for those people who said that the rain fell last night was from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they believed in me and they disbelieved in the stars. But as for those people who said that the rain fell due to the influence of such and such star, they disbelieved in me and they believed in the stars. This is a very, very clear hadith, an authentic hadith, where it is absolutely clear without any doubt that a person who believes that the rain falls or anything happens to you based upon the effect or the influence of such and such star has disbelieved in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ali ibn Talib reported from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam that a fortune teller is a magician and the magician is an unbeliever. Playing with things like Ouija boards that claim to be able to tell you certain things. And this is in fact a very, very dangerous thing and can even involve calling upon jinn and things like that. Brothers and sisters, these are not matters to be joked about.
Maybe out of ignorance, may it be out of fear, maybe out of curiosity, whatever the reason is not suffice, it's not sufficient. It is not, does not give you the green light in order for you to do something. Because you're really saying, no. Allah said that only He knows the future. But my own action, I'm saying, no. Allah, you don't know the future. This guy knows the future. We take culture over religion. It's don't waste your money and don't waste your time. The jinn do not know that. I'll give you the proof in the Quran. You read the story of Sayyidina Sulaiman alayhi salam, the son of Sayyidina Dawood alayhi salam. He had a cane, right? And he was leaning on it. And the jinn was actually given the command of Allah to do whatever the Sayyidina Dawood says. Sulaiman, sorry. And then Sayyidina Sulaiman alayhi salam died. And he was still leaning. And the jinn did not know he died. And they were still working hard. So if the jinn knew the future, how did they not know that Sulaiman alayhi salam died? They only knew when it was eaten, right? And he fell. So no one knows the future except Allah. Even Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is telling you, I don't know the future. If I know the future, I would ask for abundance of wealth and no harm would have touched me. So let's go back, and I know it's ignorance, and I know that. So how do you, what's the cure of ignorance? The cure of ignorance is knowledge. So why don't we waste our money and time of going to these poor people with the five fingers going up, wasting our money and time, you know, write this for me, hang this for me, bury this for me, do that for me. Subhanallah, ajeeb wallahi. So let us now invest our time and money in seeking knowledge much better than what we are going to. Tell me the future. Who am I going to marry? Am I going to pass or not? Who's going to do that? Wallahi. So the answer is very simple. Nor the jinn, nor the ins, not even prophets and messengers, the most beloved to Allah, know the future except what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to tell them, or what we told us in the Quran and Sunnah, what we need to learn. Period. Wallahu a'lam.